Petra. Petra, originally known to its inhabitants as Raqmu, is a historical and archaeological city in southern Jordan. Petra lies on the slope of Jabal Al-Madbah in a basin among the mountains which form the eastern flank of Arabah Valley that run from the Dead Sea to the Gulf of Aqaba. Petra is believed to have been settled as early as 9000 BC, and it was possibly established in the 4th century BC as the capital city of the Nabataean Kingdom. The Nabataeans were nomadic Arabs who invested in Petra's proximity to the trade routes by establishing it as a major regional trading hub. The trading business gained the Nabataeans considerable revenue and Petra became the focus of their wealth. The earliest historical reference to Petra was on attack to the city ordered by Antigonus I in 312 BC recorded by various Greek historians. The Nabataeans were, unlike their enemies, accustomed to living in the barren deserts, and were able to repel attacks by utilizing the area's mountainous terrain. They were particularly skillful in harvesting rainwater, agriculture and stone carving. Petra flourished in the 1st century AD when its famous Kotsne structure, believed to be the mausoleum of Nabataean King Aretas IV, was constructed, and its population peaked at an estimated 20,000 inhabitants. Although the Nabataean Kingdom became a client state for the Roman Empire in the 1st century BC, it was only in 106 AD that they lost their independence. Petra fell to the Romans, who annexed and renamed Nabataea to Arabia Petraea. Petra's importance declined as sea trade routes emerged, and after a 363 earthquake destroyed many structures. The Byzantine era witnessed the construction of several Christian churches, but the city continued to decline, and by the early Islamic era became an abandoned place where only a handful of nomads lived. It remained unknown to the world until it was rediscovered in 1812 by Johann Ludwig Burckhardt. The city is accessed through a gorge called the Sik, which leads directly to the Kotsne. Famous for its rock-cut architecture and water conduit system, Petra is also called the Rose City due to the color of the stone out of which it is carved. It has been a UNESCO World Heritage Site since 1985. UNESCO has described it as one of the most precious cultural properties of man's cultural heritage. In 2007, Al-Kotsne was voted in as one of the new 7 wonders of the world. Petra is a symbol of Jordan, as well as Jordan's most visited tourist attraction. Tourist numbers peaked at 1 million in 2010. The following period witnessed a slump due to regional instability. However, tourist numbers have picked up recently, and around 600,000 tourists visited the site in 2017. Pliny the Elder and other writers identify Petra as the capital of the Tadinos and the center of their caravan trade. Enclosed by towering rocks and water at via perennial stream, Petra not only possessed the advantages of a fortress, but controlled the main commercial routes which passed through it to Gaza in the west, to Basra and Damascus in the north, to Aqaba and Luscombe on the Red Sea, and across the desert to the Persian Gulf. Excavations have demonstrated that the ability of the Nabataeans to control the water supply led to the rise of the desert city, creating an artificial oasis. The area is visited by flash floods, and archaeological evidence demonstrates the Nabataeans controlled these floods by the use of dams, cisterns and water conduits. These innovations stored water for prolonged periods of drought and enabled the city to prosper from its sale. In ancient times, Petra might have been approached from the south on a track leading across the plain of Petra, around Jabal Harun, the location of the tomb of Aaron, said to be the burial place of Aaron, brother of Moses. Another approach was possibly from the high plateau to the north. Today, most modern visitors approach the site from the east. The impressive eastern entrance leads steeply down through a dark, narrow gorge called the Sik, a natural geological feature formed from a deep split in the sandstone rocks and serving as a waterway flowing into Wadi Musa. At the end of the narrow gorge stands Petra's most elaborate ruin, Al-Kotsne, hewn into the sandstone cliff. While remaining in remarkably preserved condition, the face of the structure is marked by hundreds of bullet holes made by local Bedouin tribes that hoped to dislodge riches that were once rumored to be hidden within it. A little further from the treasury, at the foot of the mountain called En-Nehr, is a massive theater, positioned so as to bring the greatest number of tombs within view. At the point where the valley opens out into the plain, the site of the city is revealed with striking effect. The theater has been cut into the hillside and into several of the tombs during its construction. Rectangular gaps in the seating are still visible, almost enclosing it on three sides are rose-colored mountain walls, divided into groups by deep fissures and lined with knobs cut from the rock in the form of towers. In Petra, the climate is hot at summer and semi-cold in winter. Most rain falls in the winter. July is the driest, as well as the hottest month. The coldest month is January with an average temperature of 8.2 degrees Celsius. The Köppen-Geiger climate classification is Xa. The average annual temperature in Petra is about of precipitation falls annually. By 2010 BC, some of the earliest recorded farmers had settled in Baia, a pre-pottery settlement just north of Petra. Petra is listed in Egyptian campaign accounts and the Amarna letters as Pel, Sela or Seir. Though the city was founded relatively late, a sanctuary has existed there since very ancient times. Historian Josephus describes the region as inhabited by the Madianite nation as early as 1340 BC, and that the nation was governed by five kings, whom he names, Raqmu. The city which bears his name ranks highest in the land of the Arabs until this day is called by the whole Arabian nation, after the name of its royal founder, Raqmu, called Petra by the Greeks. The famed architecture of Petra, and other Nabataean sites, was built during indigenous rule in early antiquity, often involving Greek architects. The Nabataeans were one among several nomadic Bedouin tribes that roamed the Arabian desert and moved with their herds to wherever they could find pasture and water. They became familiar with their area as seasons passed, and they struggled to survive during bad years when seasonal rainfall diminished. Although the Nabataeans were initially embedded in Aramaic culture, theories about them having Aramean roots are rejected by modern scholars. Instead, archaeological, religious and linguistic evidence confirm that they are a northern Arabian tribe. The Semitic name of the city, if not Sela, remains unknown. The passage in Diodorus Siculus which describes the expeditions which Antigonus sent against the Nabataeans in 312 BC is understood to throw some light upon the history of Petra, but the Petra referred to as a natural fortress and place of refuge cannot be a proper name, and the description implies that the metropolis was not yet in existence, although its place was used by Arabians. The name Raqmu was inscribed in the rock wall of the Wadi Musa opposite the entrance to the Sikh. However, Jordan built a bridge over the wadi and this inscription was buried beneath tons of concrete. In AD 106, when Cornelius Palma was governor of Syria, the part of Arabia under the rule of Petra was absorbed into the Roman Empire as part of Arabia Petraea and became its capital. The native dynasty came to an end, but the city continued to flourish under Roman rule. It was around this time that the Petra Roman road was built. A century later, in the time of Alexander Severus, when the city was at the height of its splendor, the issue of coinage comes to an end. There is no more building of sumptuous tombs, owing apparently to some sudden catastrophe, such as an invasion by the Neo-Persian power under the Sasanid Empire. Meanwhile, as Palmyra grew in importance and attracted the Arabian trade away from Petra, the latter declined. It appears, however, to have lingered on as a religious center. Another Roman road was constructed at the site. Epiphanius of Salamis writes that in his time a feast was held there on December 25 in honor of the Virgin Ka'abu and her offspring Dushara. Dushara and Al-Uzza were two of the main deities of the city, which otherwise included many idols from other Nabataean deities such as Alad and Manat. Petra declined rapidly under Roman rule, in large part from the revision of sea-based trade routes. In 363 an earthquake destroyed many buildings, and crippled the vital water management system. The last inhabitants abandoned the city when the Arabs conquered the region in 633. The old city of Petra was the capital of the Byzantine province of Palestina III, and many churches were excavated in and around Petra from the Byzantine era. In one of them 140 papyri were discovered which contained mainly contracts. In the 12th century, the Crusaders built fortresses but left this place after a while. As a result, Petra was forgotten for the Western world until the 19th century. The ruins of Petra were an object of curiosity during the Middle Ages and were visited by Sultan Baybars of Egypt towards the end of the 13th century. The first European to describe them was Swiss traveler Johann Ludwig Burckhardt during his travels in 1812. At that time, the Greek Church of Jerusalem operated a diocese in Al-Kharak named Petra, and it was the opinion among the clergy of Jerusalem that Kharak was the ancient city of Petra. The Scottish painter David Roberts visited Petra in 1839 and returned to England with sketches and stories of the encounter with local tribes. The archaeologist Philip Hammond from the University of Utah, USA has visited Petra for nearly 40 years. He explains that the local folklore says it was created by the wand of Moses. He struck the rock to bring forth water for the Israelites. Hammond believes the carved channels deep within the walls and ground were made from ceramic pipes that once fed water for the city, from rock-cut systems on the canyon rim. Because the structures weakened with age, many of the tombs became vulnerable to thieves, and many treasures were stolen. In 1929, A four-person team, consisting of British archaeologists Agnes Conway and George Horsfield, Palestinian physician and folklore expert Dr. Tolfik Kanan and Dr. Didolf Nielsen, a Danish scholar, excavated and surveyed Petra. Numerous scrolls in Greek and dating to the Byzantine period were discovered in an excavated church near the Winged Lion Temple in Petra in December 1993. In October 1917, as part of a general effort to divert Ottoman military resources away from the British advance before the Third Battle of Gaza, a revolt of Arabs in Petra was led by British Army officer T.E. Lawrence against the Ottoman regime. The Bedouin women living in the vicinity of Petra and under the leadership of Sheikh Khalil's wife were gathered to fight in the revolt of the city. The rebellions, with the support of British military, were able to devastate the Ottoman forces. The Bidul/Bijul or Petra Bedouin were forcibly resettled from their cave dwellings in Petra to Umm Sihun by the Jordanian government in 1985. Prior to the UNESCO designation process. Here, they were provided with block-built housing with some infrastructure including in particular a sewage and drainage system. Among the six communities in the Petra region, Sihun is one of the smaller communities. The village of Wadi Musa is the largest in Theria, inhabited largely by the lay ethnic Bedouin, and is now the closest settlement to the visitor center, the main entrance via the Sikh and the archaeological site generally. Sihun gives access to the back route into the site, the Wadi Turkmenia pedestrian route. On December 6, 1985, Petra was designated a World Heritage Site. In a popular poll in 2007, it was also named one of the new seven wonders of the world. The PAP became an autonomous legal entity over the management of this site in August 2007. The Biduls belong to one of the Bedou tribes whose cultural heritage and traditional skills were proclaimed by UNESCO on the Intangible Cultural Heritage List in 2005 and inscribed in 2008. In 2011, following an 11-month project planning phase, the Petra Development and Tourism Region Authority in association with Design Workshop and JCP*S.R.L. published a strategic master plan that guides planned development of the Petra region. This is intended to guide planned development of the Petra region in an efficient, balanced and sustainable way over the next 20 years for the benefit of the local population and of Jordan in general. As part of this, a strategic plan was developed for Sihun and surrounding areas. The process of developing the strategic plan considered the area's needs from five points of view. 27 sites in Petra are now available on Google Street View. In 2016, archaeologists discovered a large, previously unknown monumental structure buried beneath the sands of Petra using satellite imagery. The site suffers from a host of threats, including collapse of ancient structures, erosion from flooding and improper rainwater drainage, weathering from salt upwelling, improper restoration of ancient structures and unsustainable tourism. The last has increased substantially, especially since the site received widespread media coverage in 2007 during the new Seven Wonders of the World internet and cell phone campaign. In an attempt to reduce the impact of these threats, the Petra National Trust was established in 1989. It has worked with numerous local and international organizations on projects that promote the protection, conservation, and preservation of the Petra site. Moreover, UNESCO and ICOMOS recently collaborated to publish their first book on human and natural threats to the sensitive World Heritage Sites. They chose Petra as its first and the most important example of threatened landscapes. A book released in 2012, Tourism and Archaeological Heritage Management at Petra, Driver to Development or Destruction? Was the first in a series of important books to address the very nature of these deteriorating buildings, cities, sites, and regions. The next books in the series of deteriorating UNESCO World Heritage Sites will include Machu Picchu, Angkor Wat, and Pompeii. People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals released a video in 2018 highlighting abuse against working animals in Petra. PETA claimed that animals are forced to carry tourists or pull carriages every day. The video showed handlers beating and whipping working animals, with beatings intensifying when animals faltered. PETA also revealed some wounded animals, including camels with fly-infested, open wounds. The Jordanian authority running the site responded by opening up a veterinarian clinic, and by spreading awareness among animal handlers. The Nabataeans worshipped Arab gods and goddesses during the pre-Islamic era as well as a few of their deified kings. One, Abotazai, was deified after his death. Dushara was the primary male god accompanied by his three female deities, Alaza, Aad, and Manat. Many statues carved in the rock depict these gods and goddesses. New evidence indicates that broader Edomite and Nabataean theology had strong links to Earth-Sun relationships, often manifested in the orientation of prominent Petra structures to equinox and solstice sunrises and sunsets. A stele dedicated to Kozalikosis Allah or Koz the god, by Kozmilk is found at Petra. Koz is identifiable with Kosh the god of the older Edomites. The stele is horned and the seal from the Edomite tileland near Petra identified with Kosh displays a star and crescent, both consistent with the moon deity. It is conceivable that the latter could have resulted from trade with Haran. There is continuing debate about the nature of Koz, who has been identified both with a hunting bow and a rainbow, although the crescent above the stele is also a bow. Nabataean inscriptions in Sinai and other places display widespread references to names including Allah, El and Alat, with regional references to Al-Uzza, Baal and Manutu. Alat is also found in Sinai and South Arabian language. Allah occurs particularly as Garmalahi, God Dedided, and Ashalahi-God's Covenant. We find both Shamlahi Allah is peace and Shamalat, the peace of the goddess. We also find Amat Allah, she servant of God, and Halaflahi, the successor of Allah. The monastery, Petra's largest monument, dates from the 1st century BC. It was dedicated to Abodazai and is believed to be the symposium of Abodaz the god. This information is inscribed on the ruins of the monastery. Christianity found its way to Petra in the 4th century AD, nearly 500 years after the establishment of Petra as a trade center. Athanasius mentions a bishop of Petra named Asterius. At least one of the tombs was used as a church. An inscription in red paint records its consecration in the time of the Most Holy Bishop Jason. After the Islamic conquest of 629-632, Christianity in Petra, as of most of Arabia, gave way to Islam. During the First Crusade, Petra was occupied by Baldwin I of the Kingdom of Jerusalem and formed the second fief of barony of Al-Kharak with the title Château de la Vallée de Moise or Sela. It remained in the hands of the Franks until 1189. It is still a titular see of the Catholic Church. Two Crusader period castles are known in and around Petra. The first is Al-Wara and is situated just north of Wadi Musa. It can be viewed from the road to Little Petra. It is the castle of Vale Moise, which was seized by a band of Turks with the help of local Muslims and only recovered by the Crusaders after they began to destroy the olive trees of Wadi Musa. The potential loss of livelihood led the locals to negotiate surrender. The second is on the summit of El Habiz in the heart of Petra and can be accessed from the west side of the Kaiser Al-Bent. According to Arab tradition, Petra is the spot where Moses struck a rock with his staff and water came forth, and where Moses' brother, Aaron, is buried, at Mount Hor, known today as Jabal Harun or Mount Aaron. The Wadi Musa or Wadi of Moses is the Arab name for the narrow valley at the head of which Petra is sited. A mountaintop shrine of Moses' sister Miriam was still shown to pilgrims at the time of Jerome in the 4th century, but its location has not been identified since. Literature, plays, films, TV, music and music videos, video games, notes, bibliography. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.